You're listening to Miscast Commentary.
Hey everybody, welcome to Miscast Commentary, coming attractions episode. Joe Findlay here.
And Todd Tebow the Sailor Murray.
And we go from a wrestling movie to a goddamn classic.
Yep.
Now, I mean, it's all a matter of opinion, I guess, as to what a goddamn classic is.
Some people thought that No Holds Barred was a goddamn classic.
Yeah, but this one will not be construed as a wrestling movie by anybody, okay? We're going to do some Spielberg.
Hell yes.
He deserves this.
Is this our first Spielberg?
I think so.
Yeah, I'll go with yes. Yeah,
I think so.
Yep, I think it is too.
Unless, except way back in the past when we did.
That's right, we did most of them.
They were all lost.
We did most of them, yeah.
We only did ones that were related to either slavery or anti-Semitism.
Exactly.
So we did Schindler's List, which we actually played a clip from.
Yes, we did.
And then we did Amistad.
Yeah. Don't forget Always.
1941.
1942, the sequel.
There you go. All right, so we go Steven Spielberg. We go Harrison Ford.
Oh, yeah.
We go Raiders of the Lost Ark.
Hell yeah.
Indy is coming into our lives in a very big way. It's going to be our second Harrison Ford movie because we got some Star Wars going.
That's right.
But we are excited about this. We wanted to do another big one and we want to check it out.
So let's much bigger than this, baby.
Not much. They don't make them like this anymore. Right? Is that how you say it?
What in the fuck was that?
I deserve a chest slap. give me one.
I'll do it when you press play.
All right, let's have a look at this.
Am I on a job now?
What?
Oh, fuck.
No. No, it's all good. I just wanted to see if you'd get mad. You did. All right, let's have a look at the trailer.
For nearly 3,000 years, man has searched for the lost Ark of the Covenant.
The Bible speaks of the Ark leveling mountains and laying waste to entire regions. Not something to be taken lightly. No one knows its secrets.
Jones, do you realize what the Ark is? It's a transmitter. It's a radio for speaking to God.
An army which carries the Ark before it is invincible.
The Ark, if it is their Atanis, then it is something that man was not meant to disturb.
It is protected by forces beyond imagination. It is desired above all treasures on earth by those who are good, trust me, and those who are evil.
I tell you everything.
Yes, I know you will.
Raiders of the Lost Ark.
Let her go.
No time. If you still want the Ark, it has been loaded onto a truck for Cairo.
Raiders of the Lost Ark, a film from Steven Spielberg and George Lucas.
Yeah, so that is...
Ooh, what a trailer.
That's our next one. I'm excited. I miss the old trailers like that. They used to have like voiceover and all that kind of shit.
Yeah, it didn't ruin the movie either.
Yeah.
You just got like a sense of what was going on. Now it's like 8 months before the movie comes out, there's a preview. And then a month later and a month later and a month later, I'm like, I've seen the movie.
Yeah. Essentially, it's just get a basic idea. It's like, oh, he's a guy with a whip. Oh, he's in... Somewhere
this is an adventure tale from a director we like.
Yep, got it. Was
Raiders like one of the what number of that was? We shouldn't go too far into it, right? Because it will ruin it. We're not gonna give this shit away for free, people. You're gonna have to watch the full episode.
Yeah, you gotta watch the ones that you would have to pay for if we charge.
That's right. So what I was gonna say was like, because he started the popcorn summer blockbuster, did he not, Spielberg, with
Jaws? Jaws was the first.
That was the first popcorn block summer blockbuster. Yeah. Was this his next one? Was Raiders after?
I don't know
if it was right after, but was it that his next popcorn big flex?
I think it was his next big one.
Yeah. What a fucking movie, man. Yeah. Anybody, even now you watch the movie, it just kicks ass.
Absolutely. It's like, it's just one of those movies that's like a perfect movie. It's the characters are all right. The move, like every beat in it is exactly right. It flows really quickly. Like for a longer movie, it feels shorter.
But a lot of the movies now, like of action adventure movies, it's like, they get to the end too fast. It's like there's no real conflict and stuff. But this movie's like, oh, it's awesome. You got the dots on the map moving around.
Yeah. It has that feeling, too, of like an old adventure movie.
Yes.
Like a kind like of a Casablanca kind of like those types of movies. And you got like the two love interests and this big thing going on around them and all that kind of stuff.
Not too much love interest, though.
No,
it's just enough to be like, okay, these people care about each other. Yeah. Back to the whip snapping.
The main thing is the task at hand.
Yes.
But the love interest exists and is not ignored.
Oh, I hate when they do that. You know, I never hated back in the day because you'd see boobs, but now they put those sex scenes in and I'm just like, what the fuck? Like,
yeah.
Or is it, they don't even do sex scenes anymore unless you're watching HBO or something.
Hobo.
Yeah. Hobo.
Yeah, but I'm going to put this out there. Controversial statement.
Ooh.
I did not dislike Kingdom of the Crystal Skull.
Holy shit. Did you hear that, people? What the fuck have you just admitted to? You know what? I'm going to agree with you.
What the fuck? This was a sting. You're busted.
That's entrapment.
Yeah. I didn't tell you to say it.
Or did you?
Yeah,
I did. You know what? I go to Toronto and all the time, me and my buddy, we watch Kingdom of the Crystal Skull, and every time we're like, we like it. I think it's all right, man. It's there got some flaws.
There are bad elements to it, but that's the problem, is the nitpickers who watched, you know, who waited so long. And this is the same thing about the Star Wars. Star Wars had a lot of bad elements, the prequels. And the second movie is not a good movie. No. The first movie is mostly not a good movie, but it's got some cool, really cool shit, too. But this one, all they did, they are like, the monkeys, that's garbage. The ending, that's garbage. There are things that you can remove. Like, there are some things you should just goddamn suspend disbelief.
Like, where did you think it was going to go? It's Crystal Skulls.
Yeah.
So where did you think it was going to go? Just be lucky you didn't end up on the spaceship or something.
And they're all, and all of the things they've dealt with are one way or another kind of supernatural. Yes. I mean, they're like the religious artifacts Temple are technically supernatural.
How can you watch Temple of Doom and watch them fall out of the plane and open up the raft? And the whole movie's like, okay, so we can believe that voodoo and these kind of things exist.
But not aliens.
But not an alien. And not even like, you just see the spaceship for a brief time. Yeah. You think if anybody was going to encounter an alien at some point, it would be Indy.
And they kind of blow off the fact that it's aliens, too. It's like, they're not aliens. They're interdimensional beings.
That's right.
Mean, same shit.
The spaces in between the spaces.
Yeah. But the
I like that line.
The characters are strong in it. The idea of the push for Shia LaBeouf was its own thing. But I mean,
did not like
to
that.
Have it, you know, no.
We always need a sidekick, right? But it was bad.
But a sidekick. They were trying to, like, everybody got the feeling. They're like, oh, is he going to be the new Indy? Because they kept really pushing
also
him in
the
there.
Hat scene when his hat comes off and you're like, oh, he's gonna pick it up and be the
I kind of liked the way they did that, though, because he picked it up and you're like, oh god, this is so cheesy, but then he took it away from him and grabs like, it off kid,
you're
I'm
not
still
dead
in.
Yet you little motherfucker.
Yeah, so I like that
dancing with little girls and
then
and
he tried
crazy
to, then he tried to pick a fight with some guy outside of a bar and got beat up.
Well, not to mention that he fucking dissed Spielberg because he was in his badass phase. You know what? He better not be in it. If I was Spielberg, I'd be like, okay, maybe we buried the hatchet, but you don't make it into one of my movies, man. You don't say that shit about Spielberg, man.
Well, especially because Spielberg gave him his mainstream movie
career. He already was doing Even Stevens and all that shit. Yeah, he was.
But like his mainstream kind of thing. And then that's what made him mad. I think he got too mainstream for his like hippie attitude.
Yeah.
Because like and I'm not saying hippie like, oh, young hippie, blah, blah, blah. I'm saying because like he was raised by hippies.
Yeah.
So like it was.
Ba-ba-boo-bow, man. We've tried nothing and we're all out of ideas.
Exactly. But the idea that like all of a sudden he was just huge from Transformers and from this. And then all of a sudden he just like shit all over.
I love the video of him, his inspirational video.
Oh, God. Yeah, we've brought that up a couple times.
Oh, I can't get it out of my head. I like, oh, it just plays on a loop.
We'll do one day. Well, because that's a YouTube thing, so I think we can legally just play that. So I'll make a video of you watching that video and just doing it. Yeah. We'll just have like a side by side. We'll get meta.
It should be like a side by side of in a van down by the river and him doing that, because he's doing Matt Foley moves in there, man.
Yeah, he is. But he still flexes. I like the one too. Where he's just like, I can't remember what it was.
He's standing just in front of a camera at some weird spot and people are like getting into his face. It was like 72 hours with, Shia LaBeouf.
He's got the weirdest.
He was in that Sia video. Remember the Sia video? Yeah. He was dancing with a little girl. Apparently the little girl said he stunk. Stunk to high heaven.
Yeah. And then he looks like he stinks, though. Yeah.
It looks like his fucking attitude stinks.
Yeah. I feel bad for the person who had to have sex with him in real life and Nymphomaniac.
Oh, gross.
I got to go and scroll through those things again. They're on Netflix.
What, Nymphomaniac?
Nymphomaniac, part one and two.
Movie ever.
I know. It's broken into two parts. Oh, and so I just like scroll through
is
and I like try
to watch Trier?
I think so.
I got to make try you again, fun for Lars, jeez.
Oh, nice. Well done.
Fucking right.
Well done. You mispronounced his name, but then you got a good pun out of it, so I'm going to take it.
Keep trying, bud.
Nice. But yeah, I mean, it's the excessive focus on the bad elements. Like, you're just like,
that's all people do nowadays.
But like, Cate Blanchett was awesome. I don't care what anybody says. The guy who was like the double agent guy was really good.
Hey, man,
Jonesy. Yeah. Like, he was a perfect character.
I love that beginning scene where they're falling the balls around.
John Hurt.
Yeah.
Like, they're just like, there's so many good aspects.
I love John Hurt about anything.
And I think now, though, I think he will clean it up and go, okay, I hear what you're saying about the monkeys.
Mm-hmm.
I hear it. I saw it on screen.
Little too
I was
goofy.
Not too happy about that. I hear what
That's
you're saying
Lucas.
About like
you know
this
when
thing?
He's out there making his movie great and Lucas is like, hey, you know, it'd be a great idea.
Monkeys.
He's like, nobody cares anymore, Lucas. Just count your billions of dollars and complain about Star Wars.
Well, I don't think that Lucas will have anything because it's a Lucasfilm movie and so it's owned by Disney. So I'm willing to bet you that George Lucas
is it
going to
be Disney that releases it?
Yeah.
Because they got everything Lucas.
Yeah. They bought Lucas.
Oh, fuck. You think he could have made a side deal and get shot Spielberg fucking Indiana Jones?
Yeah.
Oh,
but either way, like, Spielberg's going to do the movie. Like, he's still going to get paid to do the movie.
That is wicked.
But I'm wondering how that will be with Disney on board. Like, the one thing.
He made a Disney. Didn't he make, wasn't BFG for Disney?
Yes.
Okay, so he's already in Disney's bed. Everybody's been up a big Disney's bed.
He's done it. And I mean, they're not afraid to go a little more raw. Like Rogue One, it had a lot of CG in it, but in a lot of places
it
was still
good,
a lot
though.
More raw.
No, but Star Wars is the kind of movie that CG's cool.
Yeah. Well, because you have to, because some of the things
don't
exist.
You know, because like that scene with the monkeys was just god awful. Yeah.
It was bad CG. It was a bad scene.
And he's getting his even if the scene was just him, like, you know, standing in between the two cars but not getting hit, and then now it's like Homer Simpson skiing. You know, that could have been a cool scene. They're on the almost like off the cliff.
And to me, like, the quintessential thing, like, you talked about the fire ant scene.
Yeah, I
like and again,
that
the CG could have been better, but it was a good scene.
I liked where it went.
And
it was a little dark.
Yeah, it was a little dark. And then, like, and that one guy, when he finally goes down and then the ants just take him over, you're like, yes, that's amazing. And when they start pulling him to the anthill, that was really cool. But for me, the quintessential Indiana Jones scene is when they're at the burial ground and all the, like, Aztec guys start, like, coming out of the holes and, like, firing the darts at him. Because that was a cool, like, choreographed scene.
Yep.
And that was actually one where, like, Shia LaBeouf came off pretty good. Because, like, all the ones even in the early bit where he's, like, got, like, the switchblade. And he's like, how you doing, daddy-o? Like, that. I'm like, what's happening? I understand.
What's happening in my life right now?
I wasn't aware that the greasers crossed over with World War II so friggin' succinctly.
Well, they did. They actually won the war.
Well, I know it was post-World
War II,
fact, but yeah.
Bunkers and the greasers won that thing.
There we go. So is the next one going to take place at the Korean War?
Where do you think the next one's going to be? Because there's a new one.
Yeah.
What do you think? Okay, so there's been the timeline, because Lucas said back in the day that they were supposed to be like the old serials.
Yeah.
Where over time they would change. And he said back in the day that the 30s were the adventure serials, but the 40s went into sci-fi.
Yeah.
And now Indiana Jones is now in the 40s.
Yeah.
Well,
he was in the 40s in
Indy 3, because that was the he meets Hitler and all that shit.
Yes.
But this one was still in the 40s, and that's when sci-fi became big, like 40s, 50s, like, ooh, War of the Worlds and stuff. So that's why they added the super, or the aliens kind of thing.
And if you want to nitpick, Adolf Hitler signs his name incorrectly in that movie.
He does?
He misspells Adolf. He uses the...
You know, he did that on purpose for scalpers off his name.
In Germany, it's spelled with an F. Here, it's spelled with a P-H. And it was spelled
he knew that guy was over here, so he spelled it accordingly.
Nice.
Or he probably did it I'll take care of you. I don't want you... Don't sell this on eBay. I don't know. I don't know what... That was
it's like
German,
if
apparently.
If I'm going to sign an autograph for an American fan, I won't spell favorite with an O, an O-U. I'll spell it American style. I actually have that problem. I do a lot of the posting on the... on our website and stuff like that, and I'll write all a word in, yeah, that's true. I will write it and well, I was trying not to say that because a lot of things I'm like, the guys are going to be posting, like, to make it kind of third person.
Right,
but
yeah,
it's me. We don't have a staff here. But yeah,
okay, Susan, we're gonna take two lattes.
Yeah,
we train them good. Don't you even peep.
No,
don't
foam
even
for
nod
me. But
I'll take his foam.
Yes, extra foam.
Extra heady.
Yeah. Put a deep fried pickle in mine if you can swing
that's
it.
That's a great idea. Your stir stick.
You got it. Whoa. But, wow. Totally
pickle flavored coffee? Yeah. Is that a thing? They probably have it in Japan.
I guarantee it. It's probably just pickle brine instead of water mixing with the coffee. Mm, disgusting.
It's good for you.
It probably cures cancer or something like that. But yeah, anyways, but when I'm writing stuff on the website and stuff like that, I have that thing every time. The bulk of our listeners are American.
Yeah.
But I was like, I'm a proud Canadian. I was like, what do I do? I just write it how I write it.
Hell yeah.
Because then I know one of my friends will go on our site and go, you don't know how to spell things. You're dumb.
You know, I have a lot of problems, but
you're
that's
dumb
not
your
one of
face
them.
Face is dumb. Yeah. Don't worry.
Podcast is dumb.
I don't have any friends who go on our website.
I don't have any friends.
There it is.
Who gives a shit? Who needs them?
Fuck them. Fuck them.
I did. That's why I don't have them anymore.
Nice. Fuck him and leave him, baby. All right.
They left me.
Yeah. So, Indiana Jones next week. This obviously means that we will be doing other ones, which means we'll probably get another awesome podcast covered by yours truly.
Oh,
I hope you guys
did
like the Star Wars one. I was very proud of that.
The
Star Wars podcast cover with the lightsabers.
Oh, it was good.
Star
that was
Wars
a good
language.
Job, man. He goes above and beyond, you know, man. I wouldn't do any of that shit.
That's what I'm here for. That's why
it'd
I got
be
the...
like a blank. Like a blank shot.
That's why I got the EP credit, baby.
The EP.
Yeah.
Yeah. He gets all the credit. You're like when you watch like The Phobe or one of these movies that like...
They have that,
you know,
like two people.
Yeah.
Work
and it's like, and they for some reason have to put the credits and you're every... Like, okay, we get it. Like you could have just put it at the very beginning. Like I did everything. When I didn't, it was this guy. But it's like, no, it's like key grip, Joe Finley.
Yeah.
Key grip number two, Joe Finley. Assistant to the key grip number two, Joe Finley. Yeah. And you're just like, is this really necessary? Like,
it's necessary that I am my own assistant and my own assistant's assistant. Because sometimes I really need to delegate. I do not feel like doing something and I got to pass it off. But quite frankly, it happens so often that then that person needs to delegate.
You were the basis for Multiplicity.
Yeah. There it is. Actually, if you ever seen the episode in The Office.
I have.
Yeah. Dwight becomes the manager temporarily, and then he's like, I'm gonna make you my number two to Jim. and then he's like, by the end of this day, Dwight is going to work for me. And then he basically made him like made a contest to make who the number three person was, and then Dwight won the contest. So then he gives Jim something to do. Then Jim just hands it back to Dwight. He's like, I need you to take care of
this. I love
it. It was such a brilliant show. But to me, that was that was the most Jim and Dwight thing outside of like the first season where they were doing stuff right out of the British one, like the stuff and the stapler and the Jello. And
like the snowman one was really good. He wails on him.
Yeah. Like
he's
terrified. It's the one time when
he
totally defeats him. It was
so
funny. I just rewatched it again very recently. And I'll tell you right now, the Niagara Falls, not just because I live around here, but the night when they get married in Niagara Falls, cry like a baby.
Yep.
Cry like a baby.
Oh, yeah.
Every
I cried
time.
To it. I loved
every time.
That show.
I've seen that episode
and my
so
girl,
many times.
My girlfriend's in there. It's either, okay, so my celebrity bang is either Christina Ricci.
Yeah.
Or Ellie Kemper. Oh my God. And I watched, you watched Kimmy Schmidt?
Yes, I have seen Kimmy Schmidt. It's quite good.
Season three is coming on soon.
Yeah, I
really
know.
Soon.
Yeah, it's very soon. It all by the time this comes out, it'll be out.
Oh my God.
So you've already watched it.
I have already missed it.
Boom. It was great.
Oh, shit.
Nice.
I'm going to say right now, okay, total prediction.
Let's hear it.
Season 3 will be better than season 2.
Okay.
But not as good as season 1.
Sweet.
That's my out of the gate lock. Lock it in. That's a guarantee, people.
Yeah. Actually, we just did a lot of...
A lot of flim-flamming.
Yeah.
A lot of jim-jamming.
We're getting, you know, it's the summer's ended now, but we know what shows aren't coming back, like everything that was canceled and stuff like that. There was such a huge...
There's a lot of them.
A lot of things, like Two Broke Girls and stuff.
Oh, thank God.
I know, but it is what it is, but it's like, it was one of those ones, it felt like it wasn't on that long. It was actually on for 6 years.
It felt
years.
Like it was on for 6 years too long.
Yeah, and then Carrie really liked the show. I was never a huge fan.
Oh, God, I hated it. But, yet watched it all the time. Isn't that weird?
Yeah, it happens.
Isn't that odd? Yeah.
It happens. I hate watching. But, yeah, so.
It's 11-11, make a wish, 11-11.
It came true. We're not canceled yet.
Oh, my God.
You know how I know we're not canceled yet? Because our check's cleared.
Cash this check, baby. Yeah.
And by checks, that doesn't mean our paychecks. That didn't occur. The checks that we wrote to other people to keep this thing afloat.
Exactly. Yeah, I'm sorry I said that. Mm-hmm. Here's your money.
Yeah.
$2.37.
Oh, God, the jerk.
$2.37.
Steve Martin. I'm putting that down there.
Or was it $1.30? It was something like that.
It was like we have $1.09. Whatever it is, it's that hit. Yeah. It's so well written. But anyways, I think we've made our point about that.
We did.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, we sure did. What else happened out there in the world? LeBron James is going to be forced to, he's apparently on a supplement.
Yeah.
That has made him into this beast that you see.
Mm-hmm.
And I guess in the industry of playing basketball, they've been questioning to themselves, like, how can this guy be a beast for this long?
Yeah.
And they found out that he's on a supplement that is right now legal, but I have a feeling they're going to make it illegal.
Yeah.
And you're going to watch now Stephen Curry's going to be beasting on him all the fucking time.
People are always getting away with that kind of stuff.
Yep.
There was a similar thing to
Conor McGregor.
Yeah, Conor McGregor, and then Peyton Manning
had a
thing where that thing came out on, Al Jazeera TV there, that basically exposed him for this big, like, HGH thing and blah, blah, blah.
It's not HGH. No, I know. It's like a weird, it's a supplement mixed with, like, apple cider vinegar.
It's like deer penis.
And apparently the guys took it. Like, a lot of these sports places have been like, you take it, and literally in 4 weeks, you're fucking shredded. You sleep like a baby, it said. You get a full REM sleep.
Wow.
Everybody hurts sometimes. That's what you hear too. That's what you hear all day. You're just in the fucking zone.
It's a good song. Losing My Religion is better.
Yeah?
Yeah. To me.
That's me. That's a good one. Yeah.
Yeah. And also that was how I, you know, that was the first way I got into shape was by losing religion.
Really? In the corner?
Well, because they keep feeding, like as a kid, they were feeding me wine and wafers. I was like, so I got rid of that, and then and guess what happens? I don't get...
It's like orbits. Yeah. It's like your wine has chunks of wafers floating in it.
Yeah. And then while they're doing that, they're feeding it to you, and they're staring at you and going, this is Jesus. Like, I'm like, that's terrifying.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
Remember when you could stand in the corner and put your arms around yourself and make it look like you're making out with someone?
Yes. I remember that, and I remember it was a long time ago.
What a dance. What a school dance.
I saw pictures of us from when we were doing dress rehearsal for War Show in high school. And there's a picture of me, and I was the beardiest person in the world as a teenager because nobody else could grow it.
So
I just did it.
And so everybody was like, who's that 50-year-old guy that you're sitting with over there? We're like, but, it was Joe.
So what I did, I grew out the goatee, and then prior to the play, I ditched the beard part, so I kept the mustache, which I thought was pretty impressive.
I thought it was really impressive, actually.
And there's a picture that Todd took me. This isn't the picture I was looking at that reminded me. It was actually me with the goatee still, and I had a red bandana on, and I was posing out.
I think I remember that.
Yeah, you took the picture. And then I was like, but I remember, like, I had my arms around myself in such a way, I was like, I was touching my back. I'm like, I can't do that anymore. I'm like, I really need to get to work. But, yeah, I'm going to do it, though. I promise you guys, by the end of this season, so this year, so by August 16th of 2018, I will be able to, like, I won't be a skinny man, but I will be less than now.
What I'm gonna say, I'll do one too.
Okay,
and you do one, and we'll see like in the look back episode.
We're gonna look back. Yeah,
how many pounds are you gonna say?
Oh shit,
you know, inches or pounds? Don't go crazy. Say like 15 or something.
Yeah, Let's say 15. Okay,
that's a long time to lose 15 pounds.
Yeah, I'm gonna do better
because I'm going to gain 15.
Nice, just in dick muscle.
Fuck it.
But
yeah. Lip injection in your penis.
I've got a really cool way. Nobody has ever thought of this.
What?
I'm like, people are gonna see me like eating food, and it's like, oh, he's never gonna lose that weight. But really, I'm gonna go in the back, and I'm gonna puke all the food up.
That's a great plan.
Nobody's ever thought of it. Genius.
I'm just not gonna eat at all.
Ooh.
I'm just gonna just fast forever. Nice. I'll say it's a religious thing.
Yep.
I'll be fainting everywhere.
Sweet.
Falling over. Always a glass of wine in my hand too.
So next, all over my white couch again. So you keep inviting him over, so he eventually makes it a red couch.
Exactly.
Why did I give him the red?
Mine's going to be, I'm going to quit smoking.
All right, there
and
it
I
is.
I will, because, you know, fuck it.
Because fuck it, because smoking's the worst.
It is the worst.
Yeah.
What's the point?
That's right.
There ain't no point to it, man. Nobody needs to smoke.
My father-in-law, he had the patch on and was smoking.
He smoked through the patch.
Yeah. Well, he put the patch over his throat and gave himself a tracheotomy. That was the old
Judah, your caseworker.
Love
yeah,
Gina.
Man.
Oh, Beetlejuice. That's another one that's getting done this year. We were discussing the movies and stuff like that and the ones coming forward. And like the ones we've just listed get us through the next couple of years, no problem.
Not a problem.
Easily.
There's a lot of movies out there.
There's a lot of
shitty movies and, to watch. I'm really impressed with this, actually.
Yeah. All last year, basically every time we had a movie, like we had a list of movies we wanted to do, and almost every time we're like, let's do this movie, because we just thought about it. And I'm sure it's going to happen again this year.
I'm sure it will.
But we're looking forward to it. We've got one under our belt for this season. We got some No Holds Barred.
Yep.
We got Indiana Jones coming up. We're going to try and keep mixing it up, but we do want to hear from you guys. If you have any ones that mean something to you, and that's what it is. It's not just, oh, do this movie because it's good, or do this movie because it's new, or do this movie
because it's... What about if they could send us their own movie, and we'll friggin' watch that?
We'll watch it and just do it as like a mini episode or something like that. Because if it's something that nobody else can watch, then...
Oh, because that's weird. Yeah, because then they can't see it.
Yeah, and I won't have any trivia on it. Unless they send me all
of them. Tell us about yourselves and then send us your movie.
So basically do the commentary about your movie and then we'll do commentary about the your movie.
I like that.
All right. So that will be very meta and we'll do that. But yeah.
Within a podcast.
But yeah, if you have a movie you want us to do, email us podcast@miscastcommentary.com, joe@miscastcommentary.com, todd@miscastcommentary.com, and let us know what you want us to watch.
Or not want to watch.
Yeah, or not, and why. Yes. Well, why for the you do want to watch? If the don't want to watch, you don't have to explain why. It's like,
I'd like to know.
Please don't watch Caddyshack 2. I was raped during it. Okay.
We're watching it.
Yeah, absolutely. So, I was like, and guess what we're going to talk about the whole time? Fucking.
Is that what we're talking about the whole time?
That is true. All right. So tune in next week because you know what we're going to watch next week. We're going to go from there. Happy fall, guys.
Season 2, Electric Boogaloo.
This has been Miscast Commentary with your hosts, Joe Finley and Todd Murray. Executive producer, Joe Finley. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe to the podcast wherever you listen. Visit www.miscastcommentary.com for all news related to the podcast. Miscast Commentary is a Miscast Media production.